إن الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي وفق من شاء لهدايته وهدى من شاء لطاعته وتقبل من المتقين ما شاء فأكرمهم بمرضاته نحمده سبحانه هو حسبنا وإليه الملجأ من كل بلاء ونقم وهو الملاذ من كل هم وحزن وألم ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له هو يدافع عن الذين آمنوا ويتخذ منهم شهداء سبحانه هو الله الواحد القهار ونشهد أن نبينا وسيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وخليله وخيرته من خلقه المبعوث رحمةً للعالمين بشيرًا ونذيرًا إلى الناس أجمعين وداعياً إلى الله بإذنه والسراج المنير فصلوات الله وسلامه عليه صلاةً وسلامًا دائمين وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه وذريته والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم القيامة وقد فاز من كان النبي قدوة له وإماما أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وآمنوا برسوله يؤتكم كفلين من رحمته ويجعل لكم نورا تمشون به ويغفر لكم والله غفور رحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وكونوا مع الصادقين أما بعد When the month of Ramadan comes, we immediately receive or experience a great increase in Iman, in Taqwa, and in Ebaadaat. Subhanallah, it is miraculous. And we can all admit to feeling that increase. وَالَّذِينَ اهْتَدَوْا زَادَهُمْ هُدَى وَآتَاهُمْ تَقْوَاهُمْ And yet, when Ramadan departs, we also experience a precipitous drop in those feelings, to the point where in all the good deeds we used to do cease. The extra sadaqat that we used to give, the extra rak'at that we made during the day and the night, and the Quran that we read so much that our tongues became sore, ceases. Why is that? My dear respected brothers and sisters, because of the limited time I have today, because of circumstances coming here, I just want to impress upon myself and you to understand once again the objective of As-Siyam, the goals of As-Siyam, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's ultimate purpose in making As-Siyam occur a specific time of the year before another great act of worship. When you look at fasting, you will find three major objectives in what you do in fasting. Objective number one, abstention. You staying away from food, drink, and your desires. So the objective is to teach you how to have discipline through abstention. The second one is dedication. That even though you've denied your stomach its desires, you're able to worship Allah in such a dedicated way like never during the year before. Imagine after going all day without food and drink, and yet you stand and pray at night. And nobody faints while standing here. Nobody dies from fasting during the day and praying at night, subhanAllah. Not even a 10-year-old child or an 80-year-old man or woman. Allahu Akbar. There's extra rahmah of Allah that gives us this dedication. And thirdly, the seclusion. Towards the end of Ramadan, we spend more time before the pandemic in i'tikaf, but during the pandemic, more time reading, more time praying, more time trying to catch Laylatul Qadr. All these three objectives drive you towards one goal, and that is not to achieve taqwa, because that's not what Allah said. The goal of fasting, taqwa, is not the summit. We misread the ayah. It says, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. He didn't say لتكونوا من المتقين, so that you become amongst the متقين. لعلكم تتقون means it puts you in a state of continual consciousness of Allah, a continual state of righteousness and virtue, if you continue the spirit of Allah. Because that taqwa does not end in dunya. Why? And why does fasting happen in the month of Ramadan prior to another one? The taqwa element tells us why it's important. So I want to give you two references, inshallah, in this short period of time. When Allah created us first, Adam alayhi salam gave him a wife, gave him an instruction. Surah Taha, Surah number 20, ayah number 115. وَلَقَدْ عَهِدْنَا إِلَىٰ آدَمَ مِنْ قَبْلُ فَنَسِيَ وَلَمْ نَجِدْ لَهُ عَزْمًا. Simple command, don't approach the tree, and we know what happened. Because of that, Allah teaches us the first lesson of taqwa in Surah Al-A'raf, Surah number 7, ayah number 26. Allah states, يَا بَنِي آدَمْ. All of us, children of Adam, Allah says, قَدْ أَنزَلْنَا عَلَيْكُمْ لِبَاسًا يُوَارِي سَوْآتِكُمْ وَرِيشًا. Allah said, I've sent upon you garments, raiment that will cover your nakedness, your shame, and at the same time, will beautify you. وَرِيشًا. And then he states, سُبْحَانَهُ وَلِبَاسُ التَّقْوَى ذَلِكَ خَيْرٌ. The clothing of taqwa is better than all the best clothing you can wear. Because the clothing of taqwa clothes you in the inside. It clothes your nafs. It protects your nafs. It transforms you in and out. What you say, what you do, taqwa governs all of that. So that's what Allah tells us in the beginning, the importance of taqwa. If you don't wear the clothes of taqwa, the next ayah says, Ya Bani Adam, La yaftinannakum ash-shaytanu kama akhraja abawaykum min al-jannah yanzi'u anhuma libasahuma liyuriyahuma sawatihima. Allah says, O children of Adam, don't let shaitan make fitna for you, deceive you, confuse you, the same way he did your parents by stripping them of their clothes. It means that without taqwa, you are vulnerable to shaitan. You're exposed to shaitan. Subhanallah. So you need taqwa, brothers and sisters, every day. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. It's an everyday thing. Not a summit, I reach it and I'm fine, I'm perfect. So when you fast in Ramadan, you get to that level of taqwa in your mindset and in your daily lives. Allah wants you to take it to the next level. The month of Shawwal is special. You and I do not know. We think Shawwal is special because of the day of Eid. That's not what Allah says. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. Dear respected brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is trying to teach us that the vehicle that carries us to Him safely and soundly without being defeated by shaitan is taqwa. So after Ramadan, why do we quit taqwa? We literally quit. No extra salah, no extra sadaqat, no extra raka'at. Certainly sometimes we close the Quran and we put it away. Why do we do that? Because we don't remember Allah's purpose in making us fast in Ramadan. So He informs us what you need in the next journey. Shawwal is important. Yes, we have the day of Eid. The day of Eid is to celebrate the graces of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What happens the second day of Shawwal? Allah teaches us that Shawwal is special this way in Surah Al-Baqarah. After the ayat of Siyam come these ayat, and Allah states, in Ayah 197, Al-Hajj Ashhurun Ma'lumat. Hajj is in well-known months. فَمَنْ فَرَضَ فِيهِنَّ الْحَجِّ فَلَا رَفَثَ وَلَا فُسُوقَ وَلَا جِدَالَ فِي الْحَجِّ. And whoever makes the intention, the obligation to make Hajj, when you put on Ihram, Allah says, three things you should not do. فَلَا رَفَثْ, you cannot have intimacy. وَلَا فُسُوقْ, no corruption, no disobedience, no evil deeds. وَلَا جِدَالَ فِي الْحَجِّ, no arguing and fighting. Wallahi, if you've gone to Hajj, these three things are a big problem for people, especially argument. I've seen two people arguing in front of the Kaaba, and one of them nearly gave a headbutt to the other one in front of Allah's house. The ayah is true. And Allah says, وَمَا تَفْعَلُوا مِنْ خَيْرٍ يَعْلَمُهُ اللَّهُ. Allah is exhorting us, do good deeds. What's the best thing? Allah says, وَتَزَوَّدُوا فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ الزَّادِ التَّقْوَى. Take provisions for Hajj. The best provision is taqwa. Allah says, وَاتَّقُونِ يَا أُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. If that does not make you cringe, Allah says, ذَلِكَ يُخَوِّفُ اللَّهُ بِهِ عِبَادَهُ يَا عِبَادِ فَاتَّقُونَ. Allah says, you have to be conscious of it. You need taqwa to make the next journey, Hajj. And that's why Ramadan teaches you how to be in the state of taqwa. And in Shawwal, Hajj begins. The season of Hajj. 1400 years ago, there's no car, there's no bus, there's no train, there's no ship, there's no plane. You need to start traveling in Shawwal to make Hajj. That's why Allah says, وَتَزَوَّدُوا فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ الزَّادِ التَّقْوَى. Ramadan teaches you how to be in that taqwa mood so that way you can make the Hajj. Because in the Hajj, that is Shaitan's last chance to take you away. And that's the day Allah will save you, يَوْمُ عَرَفَةٍ. Allahu Akbar. We are in a constant battle with Shaitan, brothers and sisters. He announced the war, that he will attack us front, rear, right, left. And therefore, Allah tells us, إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ فَاتَّخِذُوهُ عَدُوًا. He's your enemy, you take him as an enemy. What's your shield? What's your weapon? Taqwa. So Ramadan lives on. Continue the extra fasting, the extra qiyam, the recitation of the Quran until at least the 10th of Muharram. Allahu Akbar. The taqwa never ends, brothers and sisters. That should be the lesson we learn from Ramadan. Not that when it comes, you do extra. When it ends, you do no more. The war is on. You can now see now that as we reduce the restrictions of the COVID, more people are out. There's more killing in America. Every day is a mass shooting. Look what just happened 2 days ago in California. Person goes to work, kills his own co-workers that he worked for with for years, 8 years. How do you shoot somebody you worked with 8 years? Shaitan is back after Ramadan. The battle resumes. Continue to be vigilant about COVID. Although the governor has reduced the restrictions, get vaccinated, brothers and sisters, because we have a potential of another deadly surge. So my dear respected brothers and sisters, I would like to conclude by saying, Allah blessed us with this gym. Throughout the year, even during this pandemic, we were able to use it since last August. We used it for every Jumu'ah, and we use it the entire month of Ramadan and the Eid. That blessing may soon be gone as well, because now Douglas needs to be renovated and they may shut it down for up to 2 years. So make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us another place similar to this or bigger for our Jumu'ah and our A'yad. Bidillah. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت وسلمت وباركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا فيمن توليت وبارك لنا فيما أعطيت وقنا شر ما قضيت فإنك تقضي بالحق ولا يقضى عليك Allahumma a'izz al-Islam wal-Muslimin, wansur al-Islam wal-Muslimin, waghfir li jami' mawta al-Muslimin. اللهم تقبل منا صيامنا وقيامنا وقراءتنا للقرآن واكتبنا من عتقائك من النار اللهم اجعلنا من الذين شهدوا ليلة القدر يا أرحم الراحمين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وأقيم الصلاة فإن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون